G'day. About 3 months ago, I made a video about using 86 box, and whilst playing Battle Chess, I felt that the PC speaker sound didn't quite sound right. Another YouTuber, Jim Leonard, pointed out that the sound was actually correct. I have every reason to believe he's correct, so I asked myself why the sound didn't feel right to me. Was it just my failing memory, or something else? Thinking back to our old PC that we played Battle Chess on the most, I remembered that it didn't have a nice cone speaker like many other clones. It had a Piezo speaker. I wondered if this might be the reason why I remembered Battle Chess sounding a bit differently. So I decided maybe I should test it out. So I've set up some spare parts as a system and found an 8-ohm half-watt cone speaker and a Piezo speaker to perform some simple comparison recordings. I've tried to record the sound as faithfully as I can. I have set up my normal recording microphone fairly close to the device under test. If you're interested in recording PC speaker sound for yourself, I can recommend a video on the subject by Jim Leonard. I've put a link to this in the description below. Just for fun, I've also included a recording of each game in 86 box as well. The first game I decided to try is my own, Bob's Fury. I tried a 2D snooker by Stephen High. I picked this game because it did have digitized speech that I remember worked quite well. But for some reason the digitized audio didn't work on the test system. It worked in 86 box, and I remember it worked quite well on a 386 as well. The next game tested is Starfire. Of course, I had to test Battle Chess. It is, after all, what motivated these tests. I used to play with sound in GWBasic, so I thought I'd give it a quick test with the play statement. Finally, where in time is Carmen, Sandiego? Hopefully the audio comes through YouTube well enough that you can hear that there is indeed a bit of a difference, so I wasn't entirely crazy after all. It sounds like each device has a different frequency response, the cone speaker having more consistent volume across the frequency range, where the Piezo device responds very differently, with some frequencies being significantly louder, perhaps due to resonance. You can hear this very well with the experimentation in GWBasic. I think that this is due to the different physical properties, but also the different electrical properties of the two devices. A cone speaker being an inductor, and a piezo device being much more like a capacitor. This would shape the signal at the electrical level, in addition to the physical properties shaping the sound. I did notice that 86 box sounded slightly different, but most like the cone speaker. I think perhaps the square wave it generates is probably fairly close to accurate, however the audio path through the sound device, then speakers or headphones, has a different response and probably some filtering that alters the sound. So your mileage may differ depending on your hardware. So which sound is correct? I suppose in a way all three of them are. The cone speaker is obviously the best sounding in person and the most faithful. The Piezo speaker isn't as high quality, but many machines of the day genuinely sound that way. 86 box comes in fairly close, but depends on the filtering and frequency response of the audio hardware on your modern machine. That's all I have for today. If you enjoyed today's video, please like and subscribe. Thanks for watching, and I'll catch you next time.